Hello and welcome to another session of Let's Learn German. In the previous sessions, we learnt the two cases called the casus, nominative and accusative, where nominative is a subject case and accusative is the direct object case. Now, we would learn again how the transformation of the indefinite and definite articles in nominative and accusative takes place. So, let's rewind. You know that in nominative there are articles. Now there are four articles, out of which there are three articles there, the and das, which are the articles in masculine for there, feminine for the, and neutral for das. And correspondingly, for each definite article in singular there is an indefinite article. And for masculine, the indefinite article in nominative is ein. For feminine, the indefinite article is eine in nominative. And for neutral article, the indefinite article is ein in nominative. And as I told you in the previous session, the transformation of the der takes place in the accusative case, where der is converted into den. And if you notice, the letter r or r in German is replaced by N here. The same case applies to ein also in masculine. So, ein is transformed into einen in the accusative case. So, if you look, it is only the masculine article which undergoes a change from nominative to accusative. In the case of the feminine article die eine and the neutral article das ein, they retain the same form in the accusative case also. And also, I would like to again tell you that the plural article die is also the same in accusative die, and there is no indefinite article in the plural case. So, der becomes den, ein becomes einen in masculine. Die remains die in accusative, einer in nominative remains einer in accusative. Das in nominative remains das in accusative, and ein in nominative remains ein in accusative. Now, in the next part, we would learn through some examples how the transformation of articles takes place from nominative to accusative. Now, through some examples, we would see how indefinite and definite article changes their forms in nominative also as in accusative. Wir sehen einen Film. You are familiar with this verb sehen, which means to see or to watch. Wir is the plural pronoun of first person. So, wir sehen einen Film. In this sentence, wir is the nominative case and einen Film is the accusative case. And here, einen Film, if you remember, the indefinite article einen is derived from the masculine article ein or der. So, if you follow this pattern, wir sehen einen Film, we know that the noun film carries the masculine article der, therefore it is marked with M. And as you know, the transformation der becomes den and ein becomes einen. So here we have the indefinite article einen, which is used to show this transformation from ein to einen in accusative. Look at the sentence number 2. Sie trifft eine Freundin. Trifft comes from the infinitive verb treffen, which means to meet. Here sie, which is a third person singular feminine, is the nominative. Eine Freundin, a female friend, is the accusative case or the object case or the direct object case. Now, you know that any indefinite article ending with e in nominative and accusative is feminine. So, and the feminine article is die. So, the transformation here doesn't make any difference. Die remains die from in nominative as well as accusative, and eine remains also eine in accusative. Now, look at sentence number 3. Er liest ein Buch. The verb liest here is derived or conjugated from the infinitive verb lesen. Er is here the nominative, which is the third person masculine pronoun. Ein Buch. Now, ein is here the indefinite article, and if you look here, the noun Buch carries the neutral article das, and as you know, das, the definite article das, corresponds to the indefinite article ein in nominative, as well as das corresponds to das in accusative, and ein remains ein in accusative in case of neutral article. So here we have the neutral indefinite article ein in accusative. Ich wasche ein Auto. Now, here the verb waschen, which is in infinitive, is conjugated along with the pronoun ich, which is in nominative or the subject, and ein Auto is here the object, where ein refers to the indefinite article in accusative, and the definite article for Auto is das, and as you know, like in the previous sentence, das remains das in accusative, and ein in nominative remains ein in accusative. Now, look at sentence number 5. Er trägt eine Jeans. Here, the verb trägt is conjugated from the infinitive verb tragen, which means to wear. Here, er is the nominative, eine Jeans ist here accusative, and eine, as you know, is the indefinite article corresponding to the definite article die, and it is easily distinguishable because of the letter a or e at the end. So, we know that die or eine in nominative remains die or eine in accusative, because of which there is no change of form here. So, as you can see in these examples, it is only the masculine article there is changed when it is placed at the accusative case, and especially here in the indefinite article case. Now, as you know, these are all indefinite articles. In the next part, we would look at some other examples where the definite article is used in the accusative case. Now, through certain examples, we would see the transformation of the definite article here in accusative. Let's look at this sentence. Wir kaufen den Tisch. Tisch means table, and you know the verb kaufen, which means to buy. Here, kaufen is conjugated according to the pronoun wir, which is in nominative. The noun Tisch carries the article der, which makes it to the masculine gender, and you know that here den is the accusative form of the masculine article der. Look at sentence number 2. Sie macht die Hausaufgabe. Hausaufgabe means homework. Now, die is here in accusative, and the verb machen here conjugated according to the pronoun sie, and die is here in the accusative place, which shows that the noun house of Gaber belongs to the feminine gender, and the feminine article carries the marker D. Liest den Katalog. Katalog is similar to catalog, and here, as you can see, the definite article den is converted into accusative, and you know that den is derived from the masculine article der, and the verb lesen here is conjugated according to the pronoun which is third person singular. Ich wasche das Auto. Now, here the verb waschen is conjugated according to the personal pronoun ich, which is nominative. Das Auto is here accusative, where the definite article das also shows that it belongs to the neutral gender, and it retains its same form das in accusative like the form das in nominative. Now, look at this sentence. Trägt den Hut. Hut here means a hat. Now, the verb tragen is here conjugated along with the personal pronoun in third person singular, and here den refers to the definite article den in accusative, where den is derived from the masculine article der, which is in nominative. So, I hope with these examples you could understand how the transformation of articles from nominative to accusative takes place, especially the masculine article in the case when it is a definite article or when it is an indefinite article. Now, we will do some exercises and then see how we can learn this concept better. Now, we would do some exercises, and after this exercise, we would see whether the answers are right or wrong. For the exercise, our student is here. our student would come and do another exercise which is based on the same sentences. Here, our student would mark the nominative and the accusative. Once the student has finished the exercise, we would see if all the answers given by the students are right or wrong. Now, let us look at the answers given by two of our students. Sentence 1. Ich sehe einen Film. Here, our student conjugated the verb sehen according to the personal pronoun ich and also wrote the indefinite article einen in the accusative case. And here, as you know, if the indefinite article einen means basically that the noun film carries the definite article there. So, this sentence is correct. Look at the sentence number 2. Wir treffen einen Lehrer. Der Lehrer heißt Ram. In this, the student conjugated the verb treffen with the personal pronoun wir and also wrote the indefinite article einen which is in the accusative and wrote the corresponding definite article in nominative which is there. So, this sentence is also correct. Look at sentence number 3. Sie liest eine Zeitung. Zeitung means a newspaper. Die Zeitung heißt Indian Express. Here, our student conjugated the verb lesen according to the third person singular category liest and wrote the correct form of the definite article eine which appears in accusative. And here we can see that the student wrote the correct definite article for the noun Zeitung which is die. Wir kaufen ein Haus, das Haus ist in Hyderabad. Here the student wrote the conjugation of the verb kaufen with the personal pronoun wir which is correct and also wrote the indefinite article for the noun house which is ein. Now, as you know, the noun house carries the article das, which is rightly mentioned here, and also the corresponding indefinite article to das is ein. Look at sentence number 5. Macht eine Aufgabe. The Aufgabe ist kompliziert. The verb Aufgabe means task or job or work, and the verb kompliziert means complicated. Here, our student conjugated the verb machen to macht according to the third person singular category and wrote the correct form of the indefinite article eine, which appears as in accusative, and also wrote the correct definite article for the verb, for the noun Aufgabe, which is mentioned here as die. Wir hören ein Lied. The word Lied means song. Here, our student conjugated the verb hören according to the pronoun wir and wrote the correct indefinite article form in accusative for that, which is ein. And if we know that das article corresponds to ein in nominative as well as in accusative, and the student wrote the correct definite article das here, and the sentence das Lied ist populär is therefore correct. Also, I would like to inform you about the verbs sehen, treffen, lesen, kaufen, machen, hören. As you can see, all these verbs are included with two nouns. For example, they have nouns or pronouns here and also nouns here. So, these verbs like sehen, treffen, lesen, kaufen, machen, hören are usually verbs which include a nominative as well as an accusative. Compared to verbs which we did for nominative like schlafen, laufen, kommen, wohnen, which only take the nominative. Here, these verbs take two elements. They are nominative and accusative, where nominative can be either a pronoun, as the case here, and an accusative can be a noun, as the case here. Also, our other student marked the nominative and the accusative in each of the sentences. Now, as you can see, the student had correctly marked the nominative and the accusative and the nominative looking at the position of the subject, the object, as well as the subject in each of the sentences. So, here in the first sentence, ich is the nominative, is which stands for film is accusative, and n which stands for film is nominative. So, with this kind of exercise, we could learn to again conjugate the verb, write the correct form of the indefinite article in accusative, and also learn to write the correct form of the definite article in nominative. So, in today's session, we did the indefinite and the definite article in nominative case and accusative case, and also we learnt the verbs which are associated with the accusative case. In the exercises, the students learnt how to conjugate the verb, how to write the correct form of the indefinite article, and how to identify and write the correct form of the definite article. Also, the student could mark in each sentence which is the nominative case and which is the accusative case in the noun or as well as in the pronoun. I hope you were able to understand that articles play a very important role in the German language, both definite as well as indefinite. Also, verb conjugations are equally important. I hope you learnt quite a lot today and you were also able to understand it really well. Please revise the lessons and also revise the exercises done by the students, and also go through the sentences which we used as examples to show various aspects of definite article and indefinite article. In the next lesson, we would continue to work with more aspects from the German grammar. As we always wind up with the words, auf Wiedersehen, tschüss.